What's up, YouTube? My name is Kenneth. Today, I'm going to solve the 17x17x17 world record largest Rubik's Cube type puzzle, the Over the Top Cube by Oscar Van Deventer. Now, I'm going to do a time-lapse video of it, and that's what you're going to watch right now. First, I'm going to scramble it, then I'm going to solve it, and I'm also going to upload the entire video to YouTube without any time lapse, so the whole full video, and it's gonna be like something, I don't know how many hours, but it's gonna be a very long video, so definitely check that video out. I'm going to upload it as soon as I can, but it's taking a long time to encode the video, and it's gonna take a long time for YouTube to process the video, so when it's available, I'll put it up, and there'll be annotations in this video if it's already up. And you should go check that out too. Obviously, don't watch the whole thing, but you can see how it turns better and see what it really is like solving a 17 by 17 by watching that one, where this one you can just see it be done a lot quicker. So anyway, in this video, I'm gonna just briefly talk about solving it, and then I'll let it go and you guys can watch it, and I'll play some music, and hopefully it's a little relaxing. But anyway, the way you solve a 17 by 17 is just like you would a 7x7 or a 5x5. If you can solve one of those, then the 17x17 isn't that hard, but it is very, very tedious. And so the way I'm solving it is using the reduction method, and basically you reduce the cube into a 3x3, and then you solve the 3x3. So first, I'm reducing the centers so that every center is fully solved, and then I reduce the edges so the edge pieces are all solved, and then it's like a big Rubik's Cube with huge centers, long skinny edges, and tiny corners, although the corners are pretty big compared to the other pieces. But using the reduction method, it took me 5 days to solve this puzzle, and the first day I solved the red center, the second day I solved the orange center, the opposite side of red is orange, and then I did the white center on that day, the third day I did the green center, the fourth day I did the last two centers, the blue and yellow ones, and that probably was the longest step I took, was doing those two centers. And then the final day, I solved the first 8 edges, and then I took a break and came back and I solved the last 4 edges, and then finally I solved the puzzle like a giant 3x3, and mostly I solved it at night, but except for the last day, I solved it during the daytime. And by far the hardest part with solving a 17 by 17 is to like find the piece you're looking for. And so it's not really that it's hard to find, but when you're looking for little pieces like near the center of the puzzle, you can easily mistake them for ones right next to it. And so you have to be real careful to count like 4 over and 6 down, something like that, and make sure that you're looking for that piece instead of maybe 5 down instead of 6 down. So you can really easily mistake pieces that are right next to each other. And the hardest part was definitely the last two centers. And I don't solve big cubes very often. And when I learned how to solve reduction method, I read an overview on how to do it. And then I just kind of figured it out. And so I don't know if I'm solving the last two centers very efficiently, but basically I'm just using commutators to put the pieces where they belong. And so it's very inefficient. And so it just took a very long time to do those last two centers, which I'm doing right here. Now I'm going to stop talking and let you guys enjoy the video. At the very end, I'll play the last couple moves in real time, and then you'll hear the audio of me actually finishing the puzzle, and you can hear my excitement. So enjoy. Thank you. Look at this. Last move. And I did it. Wow. Finally. I'm done. I can't believe it. Can't believe how quickly the edges went together. After spending so many hours on the centers, the edges were actually pretty quick. So I'm really happy with how quickly the edges went in. And yeah, I can't believe I did the whole thing. I'm happy I actually attempted it. It's not every day you get to play with the world record largest cube. And yeah, I'm really happy that Aaron let me borrow his so that I could make this video. And I'm glad I took the opportunity to solve it, because I almost didn't solve it because you know, I was worried how long it was going to take. But I'm glad I went for it. So that's it for this video. Thanks guys for watching. And of course, have a great day.